Yeah. So your chapter number 17, textbook, page number. Here we're going to start the lesson from 222. So please, everyone, you can open your textbook page number 222. That is your textbook page. From here, we're going to start the lesson. Dynamic equilibrium. If you remember that before, we learned about equilibrium, the examples, and couple of reactions we discussed in detail. Now today we move on the next part of the lesson, that is from 222, that is dynamic equilibrium. Before to start the lesson, my dear students, I'm going to share another slide from where you can understand the meaning of dynamic. What is the meaning of dynamic? Because equilibrium may be a little bit simple term, but the dynamic make you to understand about the type of reaction, okay? For this, we have here in front of you the definition. Okay, but not now. After that, okay, don't worry, I will create and you will see that that will be available, but not now, inshallah. I will try to send you soon. Okay, the definition of dynamic is here. Thank you very much. Here you can see that what it's mentioned. A person, place, or thing is energetic and active, then it's dynamic. When things are dynamic, there's a lot going on. Or you can say that a person who have a lot of energy in it, we can call him a dynamic personality. He can move so quickly, he can work very well, very efficiently, you can say that so professionally. And a student, he is brilliant. A player like Ronaldo, like Messi, Ibrahim, many players, even in any field. This I just gave you the example of football. Like in other matches or in other field of life, a person who work very well with lot of energy, we call he has a dynamic character, dynamic personality, okay? Now the second thing here, that is about equilibrium. What it means? That is a simple term. You also learned about this term in physics also. Equilibrium, basically you can call a balance, okay? Not up, nor down, not right, not left. For example, a state of rest or balance due to equal action of opposing forces. It's very easy to understand. In the diagram number one, you can see here this, for example, a seesaw, and here you have a body A. You can easily see that is in bigger as compared to body B, the size, and also its weight is also more than your B body. So it means the seesaw will move towards the left side of the balance, and that's the reason it will not going to in a stable form like this, because it's here the weight is more, that's the reason this will comes down. So we can say that here that is an unbalanced seesaw. Okay, now in figure two, the diagram number two, you can easily observe both bodies A and B are equal in size and also equal in weight. So the seesaw, you can easily find here in a balance, or we name as static equilibrium. Static equilibrium. Static means that it's unstable, without movement, there is no change going on. We call this as static equilibrium, without motion, okay? Or you can say as motionless. So till here, my dear students, about dynamic or about equilibrium, if you have any question, please type in the chat. Otherwise, type no in the chat. Okay, hurry up. Everyone, please. How you participate, it's good for you. Thank you very much, Mr. Rami and Raid Majid and the other students. They sending this Ahmed Musab and Marwan here, Abdul Rahman. Thank you, all of you. Okay, the student, they just join us. Welcome, my dear. Rakan say no. Okay, thank you very much. Now, after this, I'm going to take you from on your textbook page. So let's come back. That is your textbook page number 222. From here, we're going to start to learn about dynamic equilibrium. From here, I'm going to request Mr. Rakan. Can you please start reading dynamic equilibrium?
Dynamic equilibrium. Many reactions are one way only. The starting equilibrium reacts to form the product. The product cannot easily be turned back into the starting material. I mean, imagine trying to turn a cake back into flour, sugar, butter.
Thank you very much. Mr. Hussain, if you want to ask, please type in chat, my dear. Now the question and the first thing that is going to explain about the dynamic, you know, many reactions are one way only. That we just name as chemical reactions. They are only one-sided and it's difficult. Starting materials react to form the products. The products can't easily be returned back. For example, you prepare tea with the help of sugar, milk, tea, or maybe some water. If you want to get back all the things from the tea, like sugar, milk, water, it's very difficult. Okay, into the starting material again. Imagine trying to turn a cake back into flour. What the ingredients of the cake, you want to take these things back, butter and egg. However, sometimes product can be reformed reactants. What it means? The products can react together and you can get back your reactants. This is not always, but sometimes you have seen some reversible reactions on the last two pages. If you remember the examples of ammonium chloride, the example of toothbrush, and many others that I explained you. If you don't let any reactant or product escape, both forward and reverse reaction can happen at the same time. Escape means you don't let them to go anywhere. Understand? You let the reaction in a closed system. What is the meaning of closed system? First, try to understand this word. For example, that is a box, okay? That is in front of you. Actually, this box is not, you can see as a box here. It's mean whatever you're going to do, whatever you're going to make, for example, A plus B, these are two reactants and they react to form C plus D, it will remain inside this box. Nothing or not even a single piece or a single particle you let allow to leave or go outside this box. And then this will again go back from C, D to A, B. That are your reactants, A plus B. And this one is your product C and D. So let's see what is this or what the meaning of closed system. So please, everyone, if you have your textbook with you, you can highlight on your textbook. Otherwise, you can write these words on your notebooks. Okay. Page number 222. Since this time, only reading aloud for the physical student, they will be in the class. Okay, so let's Mr. Rami, please start reading from here. In such a closed system.
In such a closed system, eventually both a forward and a reverse reaction would be going at the same rate. When this happens, it's called dynamic equilibrium.
Very good.
Do you know what the word dynamic means? You might have read about dynamic football player or dynamic pop stars. People who have a lot of energy and are always on the move.
Thank you very much. Now, first thing about the dynamic equilibrium, as I already explained you. Now, the second thing about the closed system. Eventually, both the forward and reverse reaction will going at the same rate. Rate, what's meaning the rate? Rate means the amount of product that you gain with respect to time. Understand? How the time period spent and then the amount you gain. That's called rate. So both rate, whatever the amount of reactant to product and from product to reactant, that is a rate that will be equal. For example, in 10 minutes, you get 10 grams of reactant to product, okay? And that is a rate. And next 10 minutes, whatever you get the amount of reactant from product, okay? That is the rate, understand? So when this happens, it is called dynamic equilibrium. That is very easy and hope you understand very well. Now, again, you know very well about the dynamic mean. We already explained from the beginning of the lesson. Dynamic refers to movement in dynamic equilibrium. There is constant movement. What it means? To understand this one, I'm just going to scroll down this page and you can easily know about this. So from here, I'm going to request Mr. Ride, please start reading from here. Dynamic refers to.
Dynamic refers to movement in dynamic equilibrium. How can I spell it, sister?
Equilibrium.
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 There is no
constant
movement.
Okay.
Reactants are changing to products. Products are changing to reactants.
Eventually,
we reach a point of equilibrium.
Equilibrium.
Equilibrium. At equilibrium, the rate of the forward reaction and the reverse reaction is the same.
Thank you very much. Now, what he wants to tell us here, that the definition, you can say that as the equilibrium, what it's going to explain, please, you can underline or highlight these words. Here it tells you during this type of reaction, what happened, what the amount of reactant and the product you get, they will be equal. There is no change. It's not mean reaction is going to stop there. Reaction is going on, but the amount of reactant to product and product to reactant become equal. Understand? Now, let's see here. What do you think happens to the amount of reactant and product at that point? When equilibrium is reached, the amount of each substance stays the same, no change, but reaction is going on. Keep it in your mind. Don't think that during dynamic equilibrium, reaction stop. There appears to be no change in the closed system. Look at the cartoon opposite. It helps to explain dynamic equilibrium. Now you can see this cartoon. He is moving opposite direction of this accelerator. What happened here? That moving downward and he going upward. A person who can observe them, he see that he will be on his same place. His position is not changed. Till here, if you have any question, you can raise your hand, otherwise type no, then I move forward. Okay, thank you very much. Thanks all of you, Ahmad Ali, Rami, Rakan, only one no is enough for me. Thank you very much. For no, you need to type in the chat, not speak here. Thank you very much, ma'am. Okay, it's okay. Okay, thank you, Mr. Marwan. Now, a person who is observing that cartoon, he say that maybe he is on a steady or on a rest position because he is not moving. But actually, accelerator is moving downward, and this person or this cartoon is moving upward. That's a reason you can't see his movement. But actually, there the reaction is going on from forward to backward and backward to forward direction. Now let's come back to the example here again, the slide, and discuss this one. So Mr. Fahad, can you read please here the dynamic equilibrium? This
dynamic equilibrium, chemical reactions can either go in both directions, forward and reserve, or only
reverse,
or only in one direction. The ones that go in two directions are known as reversible reactions.
Okay, thank you very much. You know very well, if the reactants convert into product and products back to the reactant, these are the types of reversible reaction. Okay, as we already discussed about them a lot in last lessons or in last lectures. So we know very well about the reverse reaction here, and you can identify them by the arrows going two directions, like the example below. Here you can see this, the formula of water molecule H2O, and that two-way reaction, maybe not, but you just need to understand, and I already upload this in the LMS. Here, the number of hydrogen ions and number of hydroxyl OH ions, they react together, they form water, and water convert into these ions. Dynamic equilibrium only occur in reversible reaction, and it's when the rate of forward reaction is equal to the rate of reverse reaction. So this one is again a brief intro about the reverse or dynamic equilibrium. Now here another example. For example, I'm going to request, can you please read? Yes. Example.
Excuse the bottle of soda carbon dioxide is present in the rod of a liquid surface and face in the gaseous phase. The two pairs of carbon dioxide are equilibrium inside the CO soda bottle. The gaseous carbon dioxide is also
okay, thank you. Okay, thank you very much. You try very well. Now, you can see this example here. In this example, that the experiment going on. The experiment, you can see here, carbon dioxide and then again carbon dioxide. But if you observe it, you can find here, here carbon dioxide in gaseous form or gaseous state, and here carbon dioxide in aqueous state, AQ. Understand? Kindly don't miss these words. Otherwise, you can't find any difference from both sides, left-hand side and right-hand side of the equation. Now, Mr. Rami, can you please read from here?
Equilibrium vapor pressure in the vapor pressure measure when a dynamic equilibrium exists between condensation and evaporation. H2O.
Thank you very much. I will explain. Mr. Ahmad Ali asked about AQ. AQ means aqueous state. Aqueous means that water, okay, like liquid. So aqueous we call it as water. you can also name as water medium. Now the first equation here, you see the example of carbon dioxide, and in the second example you can find water. Now what happened in these two, and this a simple dynamic equilibrium rate of condensation, what it mean, in which the water from liquid state to convert into gaseous form, or you can say that as vapors. Okay, you sealed these bottle, what it mean, you closed it, you don't let these water vapors to go out or leave the flask. Then what happened, they will react together and come back into liquid state. Understand, my dear? Look here, the water in liquid state first, that is your first, or you can say that rate of condensation. Yes, Abdullah Salim, no problem. And then the second here, you can see the rate of evaporation, how they react and come back. So this is all about today's lesson, in which we learn and understand about the dynamic equilibrium. Now here a simple and small assessment for you. So I'm going to take you on the assessment page. This we already done, you know very well, these the dynamic does not mean to nothing is happened, that we already explained. Now this one is the assessment, and you have almost 5 minutes. Who know the answer, please type in the chat. Equilibrium can be attained only from one side. Please. Yeah, in chat. Who know the answer, please type in chat. You have almost 5 minutes, because here I think 5 questions. No, 4 questions.
In the chat, I answer all the questions.
Yeah, yeah, no problem.
You will answer.
Maybe I will see from here. Welcome, Mr. Rami. Now, equilibrium can be attained only from one side. Second question is here. Equilibrium of a reaction depends on the concentration of reactants. Well done, Ahmad Ali. In which of the following condition do you think the rate of both forward and backward reaction are the same? The options in front of you. Unstable equilibrium, not in an equilibrium, the beginning of the reaction, or equilibrium. Now after that, still you have 3 minutes to reply. Everyone please. Thank you, Mr. Rami, you try very well, that is correct one. Ahmad Ali, your third question is also correct. So the students like here should write it on the copy. No need to write everything. It will be available in the LMS. So you just go and find there. All things are there. Okay, Mr. Karam, thank you very much. Ahmad Musab, no need to write, my dear. Abdul Aziz Tariq, no reply. Abdullah. Abdul Wahid, Abdullah Salim. Yes, again, okay, no problem. Okay, that's correct. Yes, yes, I'm going to show you question number 4, just a minute. Muhammad Umar, you type true, but which question you want to give me the answer? Okay, Abdul Aziz Tariq, number 3, that is not true. Okay, Raiz Majid, excellent, my dear. Recording is going on, please. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, now next question for the slide, on the next slide here. Dynamic equilibrium mainly concerned about dash. Option A, spontaneous reactions, non-spontaneous reaction, reversible reaction, irreversible reaction. That is very easy. Well done, Mr. Rami. And before Rami, who reply me here, He is Karam, right? Then Mr. Karam also. What about the other? Abdullah Salim, Abdullah Sami, Abdul Rahman, Shweb, Ahmad Ali, the fourth question waiting. Well done, Ahmad. And Ahmad Tahir, Basil, Daud, Hussain, no reply. And this Tamim, Mr. Tamim, Muhammad Qasim, Marwan. I want reply from everyone, please, my dear. It's very easy. Muhammad Imad, Muhammad Umar, Rayan Adnan, Mr. Rayan. You didn't reply even for a single question. Mr. Yusuf also. Raid Al Chimri, you also not replying.
Yeah,
okay, Riyadh, yes. Now, Rayan, you reply. Which question number, my dear? No doubt, question number four, is not correct. Ahmad Tahir, whenever you're going to type the answer, yes, Ahmad, you should type the number and then the option. Like the student, they write, for example, here for question number four, like here, and they write four and then they type option. Like this, you should type the answer. If you just write C, A, B, 2, 4, how I know? I can't tell you. Okay, my dear. Please, still here, you wanna ask anything, you can raise your hand. Otherwise, type.